Samsung Galaxy A55 and A35 are the latest Samsung mid-range phones, and Galaxy S24 is the latest Samsung compact flagship phone. These three devices are the most popular Android devices each year. S24 is running on Exynos 2400, A55 is on Exynos 1480, and A35 is on Exynos 1380, which, as you may guess from the name, is the last generation of Exynos used on A54. In previous videos, we realized that the S24 Exynos may have some issues with heating and battery life. Now we can see if these issues also exist on the mid-range variant. I am Mo, a scientist, and today I will compare these three phones in terms of battery life, and the tests include daily applications on 5G, Wi-Fi, outdoor GPS usage, videography, and benchmarking. All three versions that I have come with 256GB of storage and 8GB of RAM. S24 has 4000mAh battery, while the other two have 5000mAh battery. We saw the test by playing some YouTube shorts on Wi-Fi. To test the battery better, I wrote an Android application that measures the battery life, the temperature in Celsius and Fahrenheit, the RAM utilization, the signal strength, the CPU utilization, and the power drawn from the battery. Right now we are running the YouTube shorts, S24 on the left side, A55 in the middle, and A35 on the right side. 98 to 97 to 99%, all of them have similar temperature. The situation changes on Google Meet test. S24 unfortunately raised the temperature to 37 degrees, while A55 is at 31 and A35 at 32 degrees Celsius. The battery life is 88 versus 90 versus 90%. I also tested the temperature of the display, 38 degrees for S24, 34 degrees for A55, and 36 degrees for A35. You can also see the temperatures in Fahrenheit. By the way, A55 is not being launched in America, so basically you don't have an option to buy it. Now we are moving on to 5G test. I'm turning off all the Wi-Fi from all three different devices, and the 5G is on. On 5G, often the phones use much more battery due to the antennas that are connected and the CPU that needs to work harder. So again, I'm gonna run 30 minutes of YouTube shorts on three devices. Now we are at 82%, 85%, and 86% battery life. The temperature is quite similar on this part of the test. Now we move to Google Meets. Again, as previously we've seen, S24 temperature raised for quite a bit, 42 degrees Celsius, while A55 and A35 are on a lower temperature. S24 raised to 48 degrees Celsius just after half an hour. The body temperature of them are also 100 Fahrenheit, 100 Fahrenheit, and 107 Fahrenheit, which is quite high for S24 Exynos. The first part of the test is done, but before moving on, let's take a look at this graph. So as you can see, the red is for S24, the blue is for A55, and green is for A35. This shows the power consumption over this 2-hour test that we've conducted. The higher numbers are on 5G, especially on Google Meets, and the two low numbers, or the two areas of the chart that are lower, is for YouTube Shorts. As you can see, S24 used the most amount of power, and A55 used the least amount of power, which means compared to the last generation, there is a slight optimization or a slight improvement in terms of power efficiency for Exynos 1480, which is very good news. If we go to the chart of the temperature, as you can see, A55 and A35 average temperature are almost identical on 29 degrees Celsius, while for S24, there is a really big jump on temperature, and the average temperature is on 32-33 degrees Celsius, which is quite high for such a simple test that you can encounter on it on day-to-day basis. Then I let all three phones to be a standby for 8 hours on 5G. And I woke up in the morning, exactly after 8 hours. And as you can see, the S24 used 5% battery overnight, A55 only 2%, crazy, and A35 used 4% battery life. So very obviously, A55 did something proper there. Moving on to benchmarking, I tried to run AnTuTu on all three phones. Unfortunately, on the first try, on S24 and A55, a crash happened, as you can see, and the test didn't run. So I had to restart the phones and try to run the test again. Right now on S24, we are at 46% battery left. On A55, we are at 60% battery left. And on A35, we are at 59% battery left. And we can look at the result of AnTuTu test on all these three devices. As you can see, of course, S24 got the best result, and then followed by A55, and the last one is A35. There is quite a gap between A55 and A35, which means Samsung improved the Exynos on the mid-range phones by quite a margin. Also, the temperature is not higher, the battery efficiency is also there, and that's again a great news. For the next test, I decided to run 3D Mark, but honestly, in the middle of it, S24 got really hot, 46 degrees Celsius, so I stopped the test. And also A55 and A35 were not doing that great. I decided to just not finish the test and run it separately on the other two devices later on. I also ran some storage tests. As you can see, S24 got the best result, and there is also a huge gap between A55 and A35 because the different versions that they use on UFS. So I turned off all three phones to go for a walk, and I'm gonna track the walk using GPS, using an app called Adidas Running, and I'm gonna do photography and also videography when I'm outside. The whole test is gonna take 30 minutes to 1 hour. As you can see here, I am doing some videography using the three phones. Left is of course S24, A55, and right is A35. As you can see, or maybe can't see, they are at 14%, 40%, and 39%. And the battery temperature on S24 is quite high, on 37 degrees Celsius. And after I'm back, I accidentally put A55 on the place of A35. And that happens quite a lot to me. I really cannot differentiate between these two phones just by looking at them. They are quite similar, and you probably can't too if you are using a case. One thing that I noticed is that the GPS accuracy on A35 is not as good as A55. I also took some photos using all three devices, and I should tell you that I was quite impressed by the quality of photos on A55 and A35. It was quite visible that S24 picked more details, but A55 and A35 both did a very, very great job. And if you zoom out, you don't even notice the difference between these three phones at all. And I'm quite happy with the result. Now we are at 10%, 36%, and 33% battery left. I'm running some YouTube shorts and some other tests to just run the battery to the ground and see which phone is gonna last the longest. S24 tried to dim the screen at 5%, but I'm gonna tell him not on my watch. I'm gonna force it to go back to again the full brightness level. S24 is about to finish the battery life at 3% battery left. I should mention again that S24 had 4000 mAh battery. It exactly finished at 4 hours 25 minutes. Also again, the battery capacity is 20% less. Nevertheless, it is also not as efficient in my opinion. And A55 and A35 also heated less compared to S24. Here you can also quickly look at the chart from A55 and A35 for 3D Mark. A55 of course made a much better score compared to A35, which makes it more suitable for gaming. I ran some other tests. Now A55 is at 6%, A35 is at 4%, A55 3%, they are so close. Let's see which one is gonna last longer. And 1%, 2%, 1%, 1%. It's gonna last longer. Yes, A55 won the battle by 3 minutes. A35 finished at 5 hours 48 minutes. A55 finished at 5 hours 51 minutes. But it was quite a close call. So there you have it. Both A55 and A35 are quite efficient, not so much S24. S24 was the third, A35 the second, and A55 was the first. Thanks for tuning into Tecmo. If you like this video, you are gonna like the other comparison that I've made recently, and it's popping on the screen right now. Thanks for tuning in, and until the next one, bye!